Back when we learned about derivatives, we learned that the derivative of a function was another function, and that you could take the derivative of that, and we call that the second derivative, and you could take the derivative of that, and we call that the third derivative, and so on. There's no end to how many times you can take a derivative. Well, the same thing goes for partial derivatives. If you've got a function f, you can take its partial with respect to x and get a new function. Then you can take a derivative with respect to x again and get a new function. The notation for that was we would write fxx, meaning we take a derivative with respect to x and then with respect to x. And another notation is this, where it's partial squared f. The 2 here means you're taking two derivatives, and then the partial x squared means you're taking derivative with respect to x and x. You can also take a derivative with respect to x and y. You take a partial derivative with respect to x, and take the partial derivative of that with respect to y. And that we would write fxy, or we would write that as partial squared f dy dx. For some reason, you read right to left on these, so this means x first. In this notation, you read left to right. X first. That's the way it is. Okay? And fyx means you take a partial with respect to y and then take a partial of that with respect to x. And we could also compute fyy, which is a partial with respect to y, and then take the partial derivative of that with respect to y. So let's work an example. So our favorite example, which we've been working on the previous video, is the function e to the xy squared. And we saw that the derivative with respect to x was y squared e to the xy squared, and the derivative with respect to y was 2xy e to the xy squared. So now we can go ahead and figure out what is fxx. Well, we take a derivative of this with respect to x. Y squared is treated as a constant. Y squared is treated as a constant. And we just wind up with y to the fourth e to the xy squared. When you take a derivative of a constant times x, you pull down a factor of that constant. So you get a y squared times the original y squared, and that's y to the fourth. If we wanted to figure out fxy, we would have to take the derivative of this whole expression with respect to y. And for that, we'd use a product rule. We'd get 2y times e to the xy squared plus y squared times the derivative of e to the xy squared. We already figured out that the derivative of e to the xy squared was 2xy e to the xy squared. And so that would come out to be 2y plus 2xy cubed e to the xy squared. Now, we could also take derivatives of fy. We could take the derivative of fy with respect to x. And we do this by the product rule. We take the derivative of this times this, plus this times the derivative of that. So the derivative of 2xy with respect to x is just 2y. And then we have 2xy times the derivative of this with respect to x, which is y squared e to the xy squared. And that gives us 2y plus 2xy cubed e to the xy squared. Now, you probably noticed that this gives you the same answer as this. Taking derivative with respect to x and then y happened to give the same answer as taking derivative with respect to y and then x. Let's close this off by figuring out the derivative with respect to y and then y. So that's the derivative of 2xy e to the xy squared with respect to y. Again, we use the product rule, 2x e to the xy squared plus 2xy times the derivative of e to the xy squared. And that gives you 2x e to the xy squared plus 2xy times the times 2xy e to the xy squared. And so that gives us 2x plus 4x squared y squared e to the xy squared. Okay, so that's the computation of all of those partial derivatives. Now the big deal about the partial derivatives was this coincidence that fxy and fyx wound up being the same. Except it's not a coincidence, it's a theorem. It's called Clairaut's theorem. It says that if fxy and fyx exist and are continuous, there are some weird counterexamples where they exist but not continuous, but if they exist and are continuous, then fxy and fyx are the same function. And the slogan for this theorem is mixed partials are equal. So let's see why that works. Imagine we're trying to figure out the mixed partials at xy. Now, we know what fx means. Fx is what happens when you change x by a little bit. You change x to x plus h. You leave y alone, but you change x to x plus h. You notice how much the function changes, and you divide by h. If you want fx up here, it's going to be the same thing. It's going to be how much it changes from here to here. And if you want to know what is fxy, you have to take a derivative with respect to y of fx. So we take the limit. We can't call both variables h, so we'll call the second one k. The limit is k goes to 0 of fx up here minus fx down here divided by k. But now let's see what we've done. You put it together and we say this minus this divided by k is this value, minus this value, plus this value. So we're considering all four points here. We want to considering this and this with a plus, this point and this point with a minus, and dividing by h times k. Now, if we had done the partial derivative in the other direction, we would have said the partial with respect to y would have to do with this difference, or this difference. And the difference between fy here and fy here would again be this point plus this point minus this point, all divided by h times k. So, doesn't matter which order you do it. Sometimes it's easier to do it one way. Sometimes it's easier to do it the other way. Mixed partials are equal. End of story.